What's going on, everybody? My name is Sankus, and in this video I want to show you how I made this sound here in this VIP mix of that Overdrive track, which is the Glitch Hop series track, and it sounds a little something like this. And before, in the original track from the series, it sounded a little something like this. So quite a big difference. This sound here reminds me of kind of a pod racer kind of thing from Star Wars. Like here at the end. Kind of cool, so I decided I'd show you how I changed the sound quite drastically and added some more beefy texture to it and this cool little modulation. So what we've got going on here is trilobite 1. So the first oscillator is trilobite 1 here under spectral. I think that's pretty much one of the only things that is the same here. Let's make sure it's not being filtered. And let's go ahead and remove all these different effects here so we can hear the sound by itself. So that is what we start with. We have LFO 1 here set to 1 bar, coincidentally. That's exactly how long the sound plays for, is 1 bar. So just a very slow cycle, cycling through the wavetable position here. And that is what largely contributes to this texture changing over the time of this 1 bar. So that's also happening on the mirror warping function here. What that does is it basically flips the sound. Well, we have two of the same wavetable in this one wavetable now, and it flips the second one. So as you can see, this half is exactly the same as this half, except that they are mirrored, hence the name mirror. And that is also being modulated by LFO1 here, so it's cycling through that. And gives us some more interesting texture, and that's what the main modulation here, LFO1, is all about, is just changing the texture over the course of this one bar here. We also have oscillator B, which is something that I added in here, two octaves down. It's the Eikenhaus kick oscillator under digital. And that adds that nice fat kind of texture to it. So I made one change here. I went to the editing window here, and I went to the formula presets here under multis and proc squarify, and that squarifies the sound, gives us a square overtone. So now it sounds a bit different, and we still have that nice squelchy low mid-range texture. It sounds really nice, and to me a lot fuller than just that. So these two kind of layer together and combine to create a nice full and rich of texture kind of sound. And once again, LFO1 is cycling through the wavetable position, slowly changing the overall texture of the sound, as well as the warping function, which is bend minus. And gives us, again, a squelchier kind of sound. It removes a lot of that squarification that we have. While it's still, the squarifying function formula still has an effect on how it sounds, the bend minus literally bends it, and therefore it gives us a nice kind of squelchy kind of sound. So where we get the fast wobbling from is LFO6, that is on the level, and as well as the mirror warping function here. So it is very fast, a very fast LFO, and cycling through the mirror very fast on top of the slow modulation, but it's also on the levels here, which is where we get that fast kind of stuttery sound from. So we have macro 3 on the rate over here. Macro 3's modulation is responsible for the going faster and going slower of the sound, so that is being modulated here. And it goes downwards as the sound pitches downwards, so that's where a lot of that modulation comes from. We don't have any other modulations happening here on the main page, except for the filter. We're using a band notch filter. It's essentially a bandpass filter with a notch. Looks something like this. Except that I brought the mix down so it's not as intense. As you can see, we get more high frequencies back, whereas with the mix up, we lose a lot more high frequencies. Same with the lows. It just adds a little bit of movement on top of that. Once again, LFO1 on the cutoff and on the frequency here. So slowly moving the bandpass filter around over the course of this one bar and just adding slow filtering to that, while on top of that we have a tiny amount of the LFO6, making this band just kind of dance around very fast. So it all kind of feels glued together and so on. So that is basically where that's coming from. We have macro one here on the drive. That's just to increase the fatness of the sound. If I want to be fatter, I can just bring it up. If I want to be less fat, I can bring it down. Now in the hyper dimension expansion is where we get a lot of the, well, dimension from. It sounds less two-dimensional from this. We also get some kind of phasey characteristics. So we have LFO 6 on the mix here. So instead of it being like this all the way and constantly having that phasey effect, it is just bringing that effect in very fast, which just kind of makes it sound a bit more interesting and adds some movement to the effect itself. And we have hard clipping. This is there to excite the harmonics a bit. Again, beefs it up, and macro one is on the drive, which helps me just beef up the sound if I want to by just flipping the macro or just adjusting it. And then we have the phaser here, which is essentially an ever-evolving kind of filter. If I bring the mix up, you can hear that with the rate around here. It's constantly moving, so I brought the rate down so it's still standing. And just kind of adjusted the depth and frequency to get me a nice kind of low, gargly kind of texture. And then just brought the mix down just to kind of mix that in because I didn't want it to be too overbearing. Bit of chorus. I like to say that this washes out the sound a lot, which it kind of does. Again, adds some dimension to the sound. Feels less flat and less dry and less harsh after the distortion here. And just kind of smoothens out the sound a little bit. So that's what that's for. I think all these positions are pretty much default. Maybe brought the delay down a little bit and the depth to around a quarter. And just mixing in the effect a little bit. And we have the high notch filter. High pass notch filter. So we have the cutoff here being moved around now with a different LFO. This LFO. What is going on here? Oh, I accidentally changed the thing. This LFO is set to 1 over 8, so it's not as fast as when this LFO kicks in. Again, we have the rate on this. Oh, I also want to mention that the BPM sync here is off. Normally there's a ratio. So that makes the transitions between these different ratios and these different speeds not as smooth. So if you take that off, it's kind of a smooth switch between rates. So that is different than the rate of LFO 3. This LFO 1 is a bit slower, while this one is 1 over 8. So it's a bit faster. It just kind of brings this high pass notch filter up and down. The high pass notch filter looks a little something like this. Maybe a little bit different, but it is essentially a high pass filter with a notch, and both of these are going up, and this one is going down at a different rate. But this high pass, which is on the cutoff over here, is going up at a rate of 1 over 8, so it's doing something like this, like a back and forth movement, while the LFO 1 is controlling the frequency that's controlling this notch over here. This is the one that's following the slow movement, so it's just going up real fast here at the beginning and then down really, really slow, and just sweeps through some of those frequencies a little bit, again to add some more different movement on top of the fast movement. Then multiband compression. This is important for bringing those frequencies that we lose out back into the sound. So the bandpass, as you can see, filters out a lot. Basically this blue area represents the frequencies that we will be losing, and over here in the multiband mode we can just crank up the bands and bring those back in, or not bring them back in, but well, kind of, because we're not filtering them out all the way. So if this was up, we would be pretty much taking them away. So in this case we're just kind of bringing them back up, where in this case you would basically just be bringing up whatever you have left. So we're just boosting whatever we have left after that filter here in the highs and some of the mids as well, making the sound overall a bit fatter. and a bit more full once again. So LFO1 is on the threshold. The threshold is obviously responsible for when the compression kicks in. And so what this does is bring it to the left at first. So it actually makes the sound, makes the compression kick in at a higher, well, it brings the threshold up higher so the compression doesn't become active as much. And as it goes back down, the sound actually becomes more compressed. Everything else here is left pretty much at default. Just basic kind of stuff here. Just slap it on and bring these bands up. That's pretty much all it really needed to do. Could take the attack down perhaps, but that would also compress your peaks quite a lot. So I decided to just kind of leave it the way it was. And again, the purpose of this is also not just to boost the harmonics and or bring certain frequency bands back up, but also to again compress the sound and kind of just give us more space to bring the sound back up, so creating more kind of headroom, so it squishes the sound, so we have more room to bring the overall sound back up and get more loudness out of it. In this case, that is not such a drastic effect. It does compress it a little bit, and mainly also brings out some of those frequencies again. And we just have a regular EQ, not doing anything too crazy, basically just modulating the high shelf here. So it starts with the high shelf actually being lower, and then boosts the frequencies. Let's exaggerate that a little bit. And then as the sound falls back down, the low frequencies go back down, the high frequencies go back down. So just to add some extra kind of movement to the frequencies themselves rather than the overall sound. So just kind of moving around just the high frequencies. That is basically the texturing of the sound. LFO4 here is on the master tuning, but it has a macro on, so it's not really important. So I'm just going to cover what is being used. What is not being used isn't important, so there's no need to cover it. What is being used is this LFO5. This is on the master tuning. LFO5 right here. So I just chose LFO5, brought that on global master tuning. That is the master pitch. It's going in both directions here. So as it goes up, it pitches up. And as it goes down, it pitches down. 50% here, this middle line, represents the actual note. So if I'm holding E, 50% here would be E, and then pitching up would actually pitch above E, and then down would go below E. And the amount is by 9, so the if it was going one way, it would actually be pitching up by an octave, but since it's going both directions, it's actually doing half an octave and then going down half an octave. And we have macro 4 on here, just so I can turn that off. So I think I actually forgot to turn that back on, but there is pitching up and down happening here. I think before I had it off by accident, so whoops, sorry, but there is some pitching happening here. And that is basically the sound and basically what's happening here within the patch itself. Now outside the patch, this is all just kind of to taste and just to kind of beef the sound up again. More OTT, squishing up the sound and bring some of the mids out. This is all just EQing, removing sub bass and whatnot, and removing certain frequencies. And the wave shaper is just kind of there to, again, distort the sound. But we do have a high pass filter here. So as you can hear, it kind of sweeps in and introduces all the lower frequencies and starts with higher frequencies. So we have something like this happening. I tried to find the high pass filter. I don't know where I have that, but it is doing essentially exactly this. It starts with high frequencies only and then filters in. But we also have reverb. We have just a lot of reverb happening and basically cutting out the sound. Cutting out the reverb afterwards, so we have modulation here that take away the mix of the reverb and the EQ and stuff, because we also have a another filter that is at the same time that it's starting with the high pass filter and introducing the low frequencies, we also have kind of low pass filter, taking away the higher frequencies, and yeah, just kind of trying to simulate a very fast version of the sound going far away, especially with the reverb building up and stuff. So as you can hear here, not a lot of high frequencies left because they're being filtered out by this EQ here. And then we just have TDR Nova, and as you, by the way, as you can see, the reverb mix is being turned off afterwards. So as the drop starts again, we don't have any reverb spilling over. And then just TDR Nova. This is a dynamic EQ, so it's allows you to EQ. Right now it's frozen because my project is way too big, and my CPU is going crazy, so I'm not going to be able to do anything right now because it's just completely frozen, my project. But basically what it's doing, as you can see, boosting some of the frequencies, and then this blue line over here represents the compression. So you do have a threshold and a ratio that you can select. This is a free plugin, by the way, parallel dynamic equalizer, TDR Nova standard edition, totally free plugin. So what I did is just engaged the threshold and brought the threshold down, and the ratio I left where it is. And as you bring the threshold down here, you can see that the blue line will go down, in fact, as well. And you will be able to see these lines sort of dance around, showing you that those bands are actually compressing whenever the sound reaches that threshold. So again, you can EQ with it, and you can also decide to use these individual bands for compression. So you can just compress these bands, and it will raise your sound, but as soon as your sound gets to a certain threshold, a certain loudness, it will start to compress your sound. So that is essentially how I got this all to happen here, how I put this all together. My FL Studio is still frozen, so yeah, that's a good thing that I reached the end of the sound and the end of the video. Hope you guys enjoyed this sound, and I hope you guys enjoyed the Glitch Out production series. If you're interested in all how all these other sounds are made and this entire track here, then go ahead and check that out. And as usual, with that being said, I hope you guys have an awesome day. And there's my FL Studio again. Hey, it's back.